The warm weather outside seems to be sticking around for good reason as the Sunbirds stay hot for the playoffs. We'll have all the latest on Sunbirds postseason play, the new Fresno Hall of Famers, and give you an exclusive look behind the scenes at Fresno Pacific's promotional shoot. It's all coming up right now on Inside Fresno Pacific Athletics. Welcome to this week's edition of Inside Fresno Pacific Athletics. I'm your host, Katie Rocca. 1989 is a year that may not mean a whole lot to many people, but for Fresno's newest Hall of Fame inductees, it means a great deal.
This is the 54th enshrinement dinner of the Fresno Athletic Hall of Fame. Each year we try to honor some of the greatest athletes in the history of Fresno County. You know, many of our athletes are of world-class acclaim. We've got over 27 Olympic athletes, athletes that have been inducted from the Super Bowl and the World Series and racing legends. So, you know, here in the Central Valley, we produce some of the greatest athletes all over the world. And of course, our great 1989 Fresno Pacific University volleyball team is in this class.
Fresno Pacific Sunbirds, national champions in volleyball in the team category to the class of 2012.
We're here with the 1989 volleyball national championship team. We were the first team. Well, I know we were the first team to win national title for Fresno Pacific.
The unique thing about this is in the top 2.5% of halls of fame across the nation. So if you get into this Hall of Fame, you have achieved something really special. And Fresno Pacific has so many people in because of the excellence that they have. It's just a joy to be a part of that, to see the kinds of things that happen with kids at Fresno Pacific that have excellence on all different levels, but particularly in athletics.
Going into the 1989 campaign, Sunbird coach Dennis Jansen was cautiously optimistic. Quote, "We feel that with the strength of this year's team, we have a good shot."
And then we started winning, and we looked at each other and thought, wow, we're not only here, we could actually win it.
2.5 months later, holding the first national title trophy in any sport.
It's just an honor to know that the things that you worked so hard for your whole life turned into something.
The 1989 volleyball team certainly laid the foundation for a program that won national titles again and again. Six times in all before the Sunbirds moved this year to the NCCAA Division II level.
Crowd please, C.V. Berryman Jones. Susan Milani Flatt. And Irene Robles Carioca. Congratulations again now to the 1989 Fresno Pacific volleyball team.
And once we beat BYU Hawaii, we thought, we could do this. And at that time, I think is when we were going for it all.
I think our athletic trainer was absolutely fabulous because we were really banged up and just really did a great job. It was a team effort all the way around.
Congratulations again to the 1989 national champion NAIA Fresno Pacific volleyball team.
Hey, this is Katie Rocco with your behind-the-scenes look at FPU's athletics promotional shoot. We have some really cool interviews with some really cool athletes and some sweet shots, so let's go check it out.
We're making a nice, cool video representing FPU going to the Division II level. We're going to show all the cool things that FPU has to offer for student athletes.
Being a four-year graduate of the college, I felt like it would be awesome. You know, I felt very honored to be able to represent our school as well as our baseball program. We wanted to represent not only what we do here on the field, but as well as off the field. So it was a great opportunity for me as well as my teammates, former and current, to experience this. I feel it too. Are you ready? I got to show. I feel this for you. I feel this for you. I feel this for you. I feel this for you.
Bringing you this week's highlights is Brandon Tripp.
The Sunbirds looking for their sixth win of the season on senior night as six players were honored in their final home match. Early on in the match, and it was the junior, Sarah King, coming up with a big punch save here, and that was followed up by a great header save from senior Dora Vega. Senior Jay Slocum with the opportunity, but has her shot blocked, and the score remains 0-0. C aligns with another opportunity, but King again with the diving save in the second half now, and Slocum with another great chance, but keeper Tiffany Cracy makes the great save, and it is cleared. We were headed to overtime, and in the second overtime period, Sarah Reed is hit with the yellow, which led to this free kick by Leah Porter. It is headed away, but finds the feet of Jessica Van Loo, who has her shot deflected in by Nicole Kraft for the game winner. Sunbirds drop a heartbreaker in double overtime, 1-0.
And, you know, I mean, I had less years that I was able to play with these girls, but those couple years just meant the most to me. Just getting to know the girls and getting to know each personality and each playing style was just a great experience, and I wouldn't change it for anything.
Oh, well, I'm really proud of the girls and the way we played out. We came out really hard, and we just couldn't finish our opportunities, and it's unfortunate that they got that goal with 3 minutes left.
I really felt like we kind of handled this game, and we took over, and we were able to work as a team and really show what we're capable of. And, you know, we just got unlucky, and they're a good team, but it was a good play, and it was a great way to kind of spend the senior night.
You know, proud of the team for the effort tonight. Talked to the girls about, you know, it can be a cruel game, and we felt that we did enough during the regulation and overtime to get the result ourselves. And unfortunately, we weren't able to capitalize on our opportunities, and despite, you know, certain momentums and flows of the game in our favor, just couldn't seem to put the ball in the back of the net. Our senior night, it's always special, and that was the goal, to come out and have a memorable and competitive game with Point Loma, as we know how good they are. And so, they've meant a lot to the program. Colleen and Jay to come back for their fifth senior year to compete with us this year, or to compete for us this year, was just great. I mean, there shows their commitment to this program, and they've meant a lot. I know, you know, both of them, Co more on the defensive end, and more recently Jay on the attacking end, and Kathy and Demi, you know, who's been our leading goal scorer a couple of years. Tonight was tough for not to finish the match after getting injured kind of early in the first half, but Ariel and our girls, our seniors, have meant a lot to this program. Dora, you know, coming back after so long and finishing her career here, With this year's performance, I thought all of our seniors meant a lot to the team, and they will be missed next year.
The Sunbirds taking on the 2-14 Point Loma Sea Lions on senior night, and boy, was it a special night, especially for one senior. Forward Paul Eastless was on fire, scoring the only goal just 4 minutes in here on the feed from another senior, Jorge Dominguez. 30 seconds later, after a Point Loma turnover, Dominguez finds Islas again, and he slots it in the back of the net for his second goal, and we were only in the fourth minute. Islas nearly gets his third, but keeper Carter Phillips makes the great hand save to push it over the bar and out for a corner. Later in the half, Islas is taken down in the box, so it's a PK, and senior center back Luke Tyler gets the call, but he can't get it past Phillips, who makes the great save. FPU up 2-0 still until Alvaro Nogales finds the head of Rodrigo Viana. The seniors were responsible for all four goals and 10 of the 12 points scored in the match. Also in the first half, it's senior goalkeeper Stephen Waite getting his first start in a few weeks with a good save here, and he would have three on the night. Then 7 minutes into the second half, Islas caps off his night after he burns the Sea Lions defense for the one-on-one chance, and he does not miss those. His third of the night, the hat trick, his third of the season, and he exited to the congratulations from his head coach, Jaime Ramirez, who is now just 5 goals in front of Islas for third all-time on the FPU scoring list. Sunbirds take this one going away 4-0.
In the last few games that we've had, we're going in with some momentum, knowing that we can score against anybody, whether we play at home or whether we play away. And our go-to players offensively are, you know, very engaged, very involved. They really are on fire, as they say, and I'm excited for them.
You know, this is probably the most important game of the season to me. You know, I can remember when I came in 4 years ago and watched the other seniors play in their senior night, so it's very special to me. And to go out with a hat trick just makes it even more special.
Senior night's always very special. I just couldn't believe how fast, since freshman year, how fast time just flew. It was so quick. It's senior night already, but it was a good way to end our home season this year.
Well, I'm very glad and happy to be part of the soccer program right here. And that's a good way to finish with a 4-0 win against a good opponent. And now we have one more game on Saturday to finish strong.
You know, we got one game left. We win, we host. Everybody likes to play in front of their home crowd, and you know, we like to perform on our home field.
And so I think the mindset of our guys is that we can keep the ball out of our net, we can score goals by the bunches, and we look forward to doing that this weekend and putting ourselves in a position to host regionals, National Christian College tournament. So.
The Sunbirds on the road in their final match of the regular season, needing a win to guarantee a spot in the NCCAA West Regionals, taking on Notre Dame Dana Muir, and this one was a tight one. Earlier in the match, and the Argos get behind the FPU defense, but a great play on the ball by keeper Fabian Ronhell keeps the Sunbirds out of danger. Then on the offensive end, Alvaro Nogales with the great cross finds Rodrigo Viana, but the header is poked away by Argos keeper Jay Saruka. Then a few minutes later, Nogales tries to cross again, this time finding Gustavo Silva, and his header beats Saruka to give the Sunbirds the 1-0 lead. 18th minute, and Luke Tyler is called for the foul inside the 18th. That would lead to this PK from Jonathan Gonzalez, who puts it over the crossbar, and FPU remain on top. Sunbirds with another chance, but Silva's header just goes off the crossbar and out. Final minute of the half, and Silva with a great cross to Paul Islas, who redirects it into the net, but Islas called for offsides. The score would remain 1-0 heading into the break. Second half, and the Argos with a great chance here, but Ron Hell stops the redirect shot from Armando Garcia, and the Sunbirds just get by NDNU with a 1-0 win.
Yeah, we came here. They're a very good team. We were like very lucky that it was a very good cross from Alvaro, and I could like head inside the net, so it was very important for us, and I hope we can host the regionals too.
Well, it's a huge victory for a number of reasons, because it puts us into the playoffs. We were in a must-win situation, and young men performed. They were on fire. Today we didn't score as many goals, 1-0, but that's what it takes. If you play shutout soccer, minimum difference, gets it done, and I'm excited for the boys and for our program as well.
So it was a very, like, it was a new season for us, like new teams. Like we didn't know any team, anything. We just came, we did our job, and let's see how it's going to be in the regionals. I hope we can do it well and go to the nationals in Florida.
You know, you can't say enough about the resilience of these boys in terms of the adjustment that they make game after game after game. Every one of our losses, we've missed key players. But those that have been in there and have suffered the loss have grown, have learned from it. And when we're healthy, when everyone is on the pitch, I don't think we can lose. I put us up against anyone in the country. I don't think we can lose.
The Sunbirds traveled across Fresno for the Crosstown Showdown with the Fresno State Bulldogs in their first exhibition of the season. And early on, the Bulldogs were hitting everything. Junior Allen Huddleston with the dish here to freshman Marvell Harris, who knocks down the three. Then State off the FPU turnover ahead to Huddleston, who lays it in for the easy two. Bulldogs were up by 8 at the break. In the second half, Malcolm Griffin gets the rebound and finds Trevin Clayton, who swings it to John Taylor for the three. Later in the half, Sunbirds down by 13, and Griffin with a sweet dish to Taylor, who lays it in. Then it's Taylor again off the dribble to the rack, and the foul puts the Sunbirds within just 2 after the free throw. He had 20 to lead all scores. Then Taylor getting in on the passing finds Anthony Brandt for the triple. Oh, and by the way, he also does work on the defensive end with the crafty steal here, and he finds Matt Samuels for the easy 2. But Fresno State was too tough inside as Kevin Foster gets the foul and the bucket to go. Griffin here knocks down the 3 for his 15th point of the night, but it wasn't enough as the Bulldogs win 77-68. The 9-point loss was tied for the closest the Sunbirds have played against the Bulldogs.
And we shot about as poorly as we could shoot from the field. You know, and that happens. You know, the difference in the game was we gave up too many easy buckets. You know, there was a stretch in the first half, the last 4 minutes. You know, I think we gave up three buckets in transition, and to start the second half, we gave up 2 easy ones. You know, I think our staff, you know, figured out we gave up 18 easy buckets tonight, and you're not going to beat, you know, Division I teams or anyone if you do that. But on the flip side, I thought there was a lot of good things to take out of tonight. You know, offensively, we'll get that corrected. We have good players. We just have to slow down. The pressure bothered us a little bit tonight. But, you know, for the first game, first time this team plays together, you know, not bad. It's definitely something to build on.
We played real good defensively. You know, we didn't shoot the ball too well, but we stayed together as a team. Did good in some spurts like we needed to. But, you know, it's our first game, so we see where we at. And we honestly taking good things from this loss. Trying to carry it over to tomorrow.
We did. I think we did great on defensive pressure. We came up with some loose balls and crucial times in the game.
You know, I love how hard this team plays. You know, now we just got to play a little smarter and execute a whole lot better. But you know, again, things very easily we can fix.
It's just the first game, like you said. We don't do nothing but get better from here.
Thanks, Brandon. The Sunbirds also took down Cal State San Marcos as former head coach Jim Saya made his return to FPU in an exhibition match with the Sunbirds. Fresno Pacific was up by double digits before the Cougars came roaring back. San Marcos came up just short, though, as a game-tying 3 clanked off the back of the rim and FPU scored the 89-86 win. John Taylor led the way with 27 points and was named NCCAA National Player of the Week in basketball for his efforts. Volleyball had a big night taking down reigning NCCAA national champion California Baptist in a 3-1 win over the Lancers. Hoopia Inc. led the way with an astounding 24 kills and a 302 hitting percentage. Kara Mitchell also finished in double figures with 13 kills, and Emily Carroll had a double-double with 10 digs and 19 assists. It was a blowout for volleyball on Saturday when the Sunbirds swept Point Loma down in San Diego. FPU dominated, getting 31 digs from Hannah Butler, 14 kills from Hoopia Inc., and 8 kills from Kathleen Anderson, who hit 727 on the night. The Sunbirds moved to 21-2 on the season and locked up the top seed in the NCCAA West Region playoffs. Women's soccer fell behind early on in their season finale match against Notre Dame Dana Muir. FPU rallied after trailing 2-0 to square the game up, but the Argonauts came up with two more and the Sunbirds fell 4-3. Fresno Pacific finished the season 5-7-5. After traveling down south, the swim team put up a good fight against CSU Bakersfield in the dual meet last weekend. Sophomore Kendall Swanson continued her event-winning streak by placing first in three individuals. Freshman sensation Wesley Coles also turned in an impressive show by placing first in the 200 butterfly by nearly 2 seconds. Both teams came up short on points, though, finishing behind the depth of the Roadrunners team. The women's basketball team fell in an exhibition match against Division I Cal State Bakersfield last week. The Sunbirds fought hard, but the Roadrunners came out on top with a 115-79 win. Six of their players scored double digits. Kiara White led the way with 25 points in the loss, and Janae Herring dropped 16 and grabbed 7 boards. It's that crazy time of year when fall and winter sports crash into one FPU sports explosion. There are some great chances to see your basketball teams kick off their season and see men's soccer and women's volleyball vie for a trip to Florida at the NCCAA National Tournament. So grab a buddy and head to the nearest FPU sporting event this week. The women's basketball team will be hosting Northwest Nazarene on Friday night right here in the Special Event Center at 6 p.m. The ladies will rest up and take on the Crusaders a second time Saturday afternoon at 4 p.m. Also on Friday evening, volleyball will look for a second sweep against Notre Dame Dana Muir on their home court with the game starting at 7 p.m. From Belmont, the ladies will venture up to San Francisco to face Academy of Art at 3 p.m. on Saturday. Volleyball will close out their regular season when they travel to Irvine to face NAIA No. 1 Concordia. The Eagles have yet to drop a match and are currently 29-0. On Friday, men's water polo will take the Fresno Heat down to Riverside to the National Invitation, where they will face No. 20 Concordia in a game set for 4 p.m. There's nothing like finishing off the season with a match against a top rival. The guys will continue play the following day against No. 21 California Baptist at 11 a.m. Men's basketball will endeavor on their first road game of the season when they drive to St. George, Utah this weekend for the Dixie State Classic. The men take on Colorado Mesa on Friday at 4:30 p.m. and then face off with the Tritons from UC San Diego the next day, with the game also starting at 4:30 p.m. After an eventful week for men's basketball, our guys will return to the Valley just in time to show their stuff in a game on Monday against UC Merced in Merced at 7 p.m. Women's basketball will take their talent on the road to Pomona on Wednesday. The ladies will tip off against the Cal Poly Pomona Broncos at 6 p.m. Start planning ahead for next weekend when the Sunbirds host the NCCAA West Region Tournament in both volleyball and men's soccer. Play begins next Thursday and goes through Saturday, so clear your schedules now. Remember, you can stay up to date with all the latest news, scores, and highlights for the Sunbirds at fpuathletics.com and on Twitter at fpusunbirds. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time right here on Inside Fresno Pacific Athletics.